There seems to be a fine line between coincidence and irony.
You sure about that map?
Unfortunately, there was some nonsense about the discovery of the real King Arthur's tomb here years ago, soon discredited. And yet another roadside attraction was born.
Well, let's see what we can see, shall we? At least it should be educational. Either housekeeping should be fired, or no one's been inside for months. This place has seen better days.
It's been condemned since the death of the owner, one Professor Worth. I shudder to think that at one time he had students.
They must be electric. I'll have to find the power main.
The place is locked up pretty tight on the ground floor. Probably have to try up higher.
And we have power. There's no difference between stupid and charming with you, is there?
So that there wouldst be no squabbling betwixt ye knights, Merlin bequeathed upon Arthur yon round table, which was the table neither square nor buttressed, but circular in form. 'Twas a symbol of unity and equality, and 'twas from whither Arthur's knights took their name, the Knights of the Round Table.
I'm assuming you're taking notes.
Yeah, verily.
Thus didst King Arthur gather round his person ye greatest knights of ye realm, that they might be paragons of chivalry and virtue. Gaily they cam'st, yea, and 'twas an assembly as hadst not before been seeneth, and verily there was much rejoicing.
Hey, push the button again. It's like electroshock therapy for Alice there.
I like to think it keeps him sharp.
Behold ye holy grail! Such a vision of yon cup of Christ didst verily appeareth to Arthur and his knights, whereupon several amongst them didst quest for to find it anon. And they 'twere four, Lancelot, Galahad, Percival, and Bors. And yonder they journeyed, none e'er returning. Though Galahad did see the grail, and yea, his heart was gladdened muchly.
How did they know he found it if he didn't return? Exactly!
And what of Excalibur, ye mighty sword of legend? 'Twas Merlin who did spring at Arthur to yon magical lake wherein did swell ye lady of the lake. And from her hand didst Arthur take Excalibur. And yea, ye sword couldst ne'er be broken, for 'twas its magic.
I'm confused. Weren't Excalibur and the Sword in the Stone the same thing? They were two bloody different swords!
Now, Zip, that was too easy. Archaeology is half metaphor, you know. Grunting Saxon or the Roman fascist that Alistair believes the whole legend was built around. This is where the truth behind the myth is supposed to be explained. But it's been turned into a warehouse.
Fitting. There's been so little truth everywhere else. Why start here? The only factual basis behind the King Arthur myths died centuries before this place was built.
Give Professor Worth some credit. If he had to close an exhibit for renovations, at least he picked the most boring one. This must be our kindly professor's office space.
Done up as spottily as his reputation.
Said the pot to the kettle.
Professor Worth says here that the tomb of King Arthur, the one his museum's built over, is a fake.
No surprise there. At least he knows his museum is for tourists.
But Professor Worth believed the sarcophagus was placed here by Arthur's contemporaries to lure thieves from the gravesite of the actual King Arthur.
Who doesn't exist?
That's where you and the Professor differ. This definitely isn't Arthur's tomb.
What's wrong with it?
I've seen enough tombs in my life to know when I'm looking at a cenotaph.
Say who?
A diversion. This place is trying too hard. It's hiding something.
A body?
No, that's the problem. It's authentic enough for its age, but its age isn't entirely authentic.
And what does that mean? She's saying that the sarcophagus is from around the 11th century, which is when the Arthurian myths were invented. The real Arthur came 5 centuries before, so it's old, but, well, not old enough.
It could be anyone in here, if there's anyone at all. No, there has to be something else. Raise this door. Please, Alistair. This will take some concentration.
Yeah, pipe down, Alistair. Or I won't let you sit up front with me anymore.
Thank you.
down safely.
So am I.
That doesn't mean you don't have to be quiet anymore. Looks like there's oil seeping into the water table. Who knows how long it's been burning?
I wonder if the architect's design deliberately took this into account.
There's your answer, Alistair.
Wow. You know you're gonna ruin your boots.
Not on the path I'll need to take.
Maybe there's a way up and over.
This looks like my garbage disposal.
I hope you're not leaping through there, Laura. There must be a way to stop them up.
I certainly hope so. Been worth trying just to hear you lads squeal about it.
stand on that plate for her.
Why don't you go down and hold that door open? Up on the shelf over there? You could use that on the pressure plate. It's not a crate, it's a coffin. Someone's revered ancestor is in there.
Sir.
If we're through having fun, it's time to get back to business.
I'll take this time to adjust some travel arrangements I made. It shouldn't take too long.
Coward. Don't worry, Laura. I've still got an eye on you. Probably won't be able to hear each other too well when you're underwater, though.
There is a god.
Hey, I heard that.
brilliant.
That is interesting.
Locked.
What? Whoever built this place didn't think the Lake of Fire and the Blades of Death were enough?
Real. They're all here. The court of Camelot.
You're sure about this? King Arthur, who wast verily of ye loins of Usurp and Dragon?
I've no doubt about the authenticity of this tomb, Alistair. Arthur was the 11th century figure that became legend. The once and future king was as real then as the air I'm breathing now.
I don't know, Laura.
Excalibur. The sword in the stone. That's how it always goes, isn't it?
Pardon?
Swords in stones, Alistair. They're part of the monomyth. There wasn't just one Excalibur or one Merlin. We keep seeing swords and daises all over the world because they were everywhere.
So you're saying that everywhere they went, they raised up kings, shaping the course of human destiny?
Well, it's a possibility.
Who? And what happened to them and their swords?
Perhaps they're in Avalon. It's as good a place as any. Except our Merlin was killed and our Excalibur was left in pieces in the hands of the locals.
So where's Avalon?
I don't know. On the other side of the looking glass, perhaps? It says Bedivere returned a fragment of Excalibur to Arthur after the other pieces were carried off by the knights.
Where'd they go?
To find Avalon, perhaps. The quest for the Holy Grail. Lancelot, Galahad, Percival, and Bors. Their tombs are empty.
It says this fragment was left with Arthur to help him leave this mausoleum when the time came. Perhaps it will help me instead. King of the Britons. I wouldn't take Excalibur if I didn't need it, so I hope you can forgive me.
Mara, there's something going on up here. Alistair, you see that?
See what?
Oh, hell! Get your head!
Zip!
Get
Alistair!
Laura!
Zip, what's happening?
Thank you.
Hello, lads.
Hey, Lara. What's up?
They didn't make off with your credit cards, did they? Is everything all right? Alistair?
I'm fine. Just not my usual evening routine.
Then let's go home.
Brilliant. This is brilliant. King Arthur was real. The Knights of the Round Table were real. And now we have Excalibur right here in front of us. Those stodgy bastards at Oxford will have kittens when they hear of this.
It's even bigger than that, Alistair. What Arthur called Excalibur is a powerful artifact that predates him by millennia.
Well, it's still in pieces. Who brought the superglue?
While I was in Ghana, I asked you to look around for the Galali key. No luck, I take it?
It was not among your father's collection.
Or his records.
It wasn't in Ghana either. Or Rutland was... Hello? What's this? I've seen you before, haven't I? Hang on. A striking resemblance, don't you think?
The pendant was a gift from your father. I never knew from where he had obtained it, until now.
Where is it now?
It's in the Himalayas. My mother had it with her. Zip, Alistair, I'm going to Nepal. Please make the usual arrangements.
We'll take care of it. Come on, man.
Not to presume, Lady Croft, but I'd hoped you wouldn't try to use the sword yourself after what happened to your mother.
She removed the sword. That's what killed her. I don't intend to do the same. If my father had known any of this, he tried so hard, and they hated him for it.
No one hated him, Lara.
It bloody well wasn't love, was it? His reputation was destroyed. Now there's more than one thing to be salvaged from that mountaintop.
The wreckage should be just on the other side.
I can't see anything. You sure you're in the right spot?
I never forget a face.